Welcome to another video. In this video, we're going to review the customer profile. You'll most likely need to review these customer profiles often. Before we review a customer, let's go to File and click on Server Preferences. And notice how there is a Compliance tab. Notice how these are all settings for the compliance. For example, we have an option where it checks customers against all sanction lists, and this could be turned off, for example, or even turned on. You can customize anything that fits your needs. However, for this option, automatically check customer before every invoice. For profile review frequency in days, for example, say if a customer hadn't done a transaction in the past 360 days, you're going to want to review that customer. This is to validate that the customer is still active or if their information needs updating, etc. And then we have profile review frequency for high-risk customers in days. Please note that this value must be lower than the profile review frequency in days above because this is for normal customers. However, for high-risk customers, you're most likely going to want to check them more frequently. So when reviewing this section, just make sure that this value is indeed smaller than this one. Also, please be aware that this feature is only available to the administrators. Now, let's get into reviewing the customer. At the bottom right-hand corner, notice how there's a drop-down menu for Find Customers, and you can actually find all the customers that are due for review. And it will tell you exactly how many records have matched and are due for review. Now, you can also search for the customer you'd like to review and click on Review Customer Profile at the bottom. So first, you're going to want to make sure that this customer's information is all filled out. If not, then go ahead and do so. And then once everything's complete, you can click on Company and Occupation has been checked. And then also check if the phone number and their email is all filled out. And if so, click on this. And it'll say that phone and email is verified. Now let's go to the next page. So we do the same thing here, make sure everything is correct. You want to make sure the expiry date is not expired. If it was, this box would be red. And then once everything's good again, click on Picture ID is verified. And then let's click on the next page. Here we can see everything is complete. And again, click on Address Verified. At the bottom here, we have a green bar indicating how complete this review was. So in our case, clicking that we have checked everything and everything's good to go. The review is complete and we can say save. However, if you go through this process and this green bar is not fully at the end here, that means you're most likely missing something. And there might be a note telling you what that is and you may need to do another review. And now since everything is good to go, we're going to say save review. And now you have reviewed your customer. If you click on the customer, the review of this customer will be saved on the review log tab here, and it will indicate the date it was completed, who the reviewer was, what was checked and what was not checked, and any notes you had regarding that customer. For this section, this is typically done by the tellers and this is not done by the compliance officers. Also note how if you go to the drop-down menu here and you click on KYC review log, and if you click on T up here, which T typically stands for today, you can see all the reviews you had completed in this day. And you can confirm that that review was successful. Thank you and have a good day.